In this midterm election, the fight for control of the Senate dominates the headlines. But as Jacob Kauffman of KUAR Public Radio in Little Rock, Arkansas reports, there are issues like raising the minimum wage, which might be key to driving voters to the polls.
We're letting you know so you can go out and vote for this.
Going door to door in the Oak Forest neighborhood of Little Rock, Gloria Smith is urging people to get out to vote for a minimum wage increase.
And I'm just coming out telling you to go out and vote for the minimum wage, $8.50 an hour.
Yeah. Right now in Arkansas.
Currently, the Arkansas minimum wage is $6.25 an hour, a dollar less than the federal minimum wage. Georgia and Wyoming are the only other states to have rates below the federal level. The proposal on the Arkansas ballot would raise the rate in stages to $8.50 an hour by January 2017.
And I know you're a registered voter.
Smith says such an increase is long overdue.
It would help a lot of families, especially mothers that have children in daycare. A lot of people have to go to churches to get food to make out because they can't afford to buy the food. So I like to see businesses pay people what they're worth.
I'm gonna get to go to school today, y'all.
36-year-old Gregory Stewart would certainly like to see employers pay a higher wage. He holds down two jobs throughout the year at a restaurant and a ballpark. And still, to make ends meet, he and his two daughters had to move in with his mother and grandmother.
She's a big girl.
He says raising his wages would make a huge difference for his family.
Certainly being able to provide a good home life where they can have at least three very good meals a day.
Oh, okay.
But Roger Lacey, who owns a janitorial service company, says he believes raising the minimum wage would actually hurt the people it intends to help. Lacey employs more than 200 workers. Most are part-time and nearly all earn the minimum wage.
My big opposition to the minimum wage is what it does to the teenage community. Currently, about 24% of minimum wage workers are teenagers. When you price the per hour rate to where it's people don't want to hire them, then they won't get on the ladder to getting a job.
Arkansas is one of five states where voters will decide this fall whether to raise their state's minimum wage. Ironically, four of the five states are Republican strongholds. Democrats are hoping that these measures will help spur liberal-leaning voters to turn out in greater numbers, which could help Democratic candidates up and down the ballot.
There's a large number of voters that vote in presidential elections but drop off or don't vote in off-year elections. So issues like the minimum wage and ballot initiatives are meant to kind of reach those voters to get them to go to the polls.
It's really Gregory Schufelt is a political science professor at the University of Arkansas at Little Rock. He says it's no accident that in most of the states where minimum wage is on the ballot, there's also a competitive Senate race. In Arkansas, the race is between two-term incumbent Mark Pryor, the Democrat, and Republican U.S. Representative Tom Cotton. Pryor is the first statewide elected official in Arkansas to support the increase. Cotton, until recently, said he opposed minimum wage increases. But just 2 days after the measure was officially put on the ballot, he said he would vote for the November initiative. With polls showing overwhelming support for the measure, Republicans have virtually no choice but to indicate approval, says Schufelt.
They might have philosophical reasons or economic reasons why they think it might be a bad idea, but politically, it's a non-starter for them.
My dad started this mill in 1947.
That is certainly the case with State Representative David Branscombe.
People don't realize the expenses.
He owns a cattle ranch and a sawmill in northern Arkansas. He pays above the minimum wage, but says as a businessman, he's opposed to having the government dictate the wages he pays employees.
The reality is, in a small business environment that I'm in, I can only pay so much. I mean, I am dictated by the national markets, from the lumber market to tie market. They all tell me what I'm gonna get. I have no control over that. But if the government's gonna come in and say, well, you're gonna have to do this, then maybe I can't, maybe I shut down.
But as a representative, Branscombe says he's going to have to support the ballot initiative.
Well, that's because, 80% of the people are for it. I mean, it's hard to come out and be, you know, strongly opposed to a position when everybody wants to try to help everybody out. I mean, you know, that's why we're here, to try to help people. But as a Republican, you don't want to hurt business. So it's a delicate balancing act that we have to do.
Oh, yeah.
Patrick Hayes is the former mayor of North Little Rock, a Democrat. He's running for a U.S. House seat in Arkansas's most Democratic-leaning district.
Oh, that's right, okay.
He recently greeted people at the Taste of the Town, an annual festival featuring local restaurants. He says he's hopeful that with Republicans saying they support minimum wage measures, there may even be enough bipartisan cooperation to get a federal increase passed.
There needs to be an increase, and whether it be 10-10 or whether it be something less, you know, I'd hope that we could arrive at that on a bipartisan basis and then go forward, because I think the country, country will benefit by that.
How you doing?
Prospects of a federal increase are unlikely. Many Democrats, including Senator Pryor, opposed to a higher rate. But passage of the five different state measures is quite likely, especially if history is any guide. Since 2002, 10 states have voted on minimum wage increases, and all 10 measures were approved with overwhelming support.